Hello, welcome to my world of fragrance. Today I have a very special fragranced house overview for you. It is of the one and only Maison Francis Coutjean. Maison Francis Coutjean, or MFK, is a contemporary niche fragrance house that was launched in 2009 by the perfumer of the same name. Francis Coutjean is a French-born perfumer with Armenian heritage. He has quite a portfolio under his belt. He's created fragrances such as Le Mal from Jean-Paul Gaultier, For Her from Narciso Rodriguez, Elizabeth Arden Green Tea. He's created fragrances for Acqua di Parma and Juliet Has a Gun. So he is a quite famous, renowned perfumer. MFK is found in a lot of larger department stores around the globe. It is LVMH owned, so it has good financial backing behind it. It is not a fragrance house that you would have to look long and far for. So the line itself consists of 17 fragrances, and they come in 70 ml, or most of them come in 70 ml or 200 ml bottles. So the first one I'm going to be talking to you about is the one that really caught my eye at first, or caught my nose at first. It was Love at First Sniff. And it was a Consoir from MFK. So I have the 70 ml bottle here. This is a beautiful contemporary amber. It's an oriental, of course. Worth noting from MFK is that Francis Coutjean created this fragrance house as a modern answer to the traditional French fragrances. It's a clean amber fragrance, so it's not your typical heavy lingering amber scent. It's a beautiful, sophisticated, modern, crisp amber, I would say. It's one that I can pull off, and usually I have an issue with amber fragrances because they just end up smelling like rotten fruit on me. It's just something to do with my skin composition. It does not work well, but I can wear this one. The sillage on this is impeccable, so the projection is very good. You can be on the other side of the room and somebody will smell this, compliment you on this, and the longevity as well is beautiful. So definitely one worth checking out from MFK. Next is Acqua Celestia from MFK. This one was released in 2017, and it is a fresh citrus. It's an eau de toilette formulation, so it's not as long lasting as the EDPs in the line. It is one that you'd have to respray, and also the nature of it means that you just have to respray. But the sillage on it is incredible. It is a beautifully blended lemon with musk undertones. So there are two other aquas in the line from MFK, and this one is my favorite. Aqua Universalis is another popular one. That one has like a floral bouquet mixed in there, whereas this one is minty fresh with musk. So a beautiful one for ladies and gents, and yeah, worth a sniff. Next, I'm going to be talking to you about Apam. This is a beautiful, unique fragrance. It is a oriental. The one that I have is pour homme. There's also pour femme, but this one is, you know, easily worn on a lady. I wear it myself. This one is quite unique. It's orange blossom, cedar, and amber mixed with a whole lot of other things. The way that these fragrances are blended by Francis Coutjean is just amazing. It's one that, when worn, becomes one with the skin, so it would make a great signature fragrance. If you're interested in a different type of oriental fragrance, one that isn't your typical amber, etc., then check this one out. So next from my collection of MFK fragrances is, of course, an oud. I had to pick one out. And this is Oud Silk Mood. So there are others in the line. This one is a prominent Bulgarian rose mixed with oud. It's very beautiful. It is one that I wouldn't say blends well with the skin. It actually just smells the way that it smells, no matter who is wearing it, in my opinion. But it is a sillage beast. It's great longevity, and it's a very modern answer to the classic oud. If you like the Byredo oud fragrances, then this is one that would be worth for you to check out. So the next fragrance I'm going to talk about was not Love at First Sniff. It's one that grew on me, and it is one that is a little bit controversial in the fragrance community. So it is a Baccarat Rouge 540, if you're going to say the full name, and it is this beautiful. This is the 200 ml. I do own the 70 ml, not 1, 2, 3, 4, but 5 bottles of Baccarat Rouge. I have a problem with this scent. It is one that makes a beautiful signature scent. So this is the Extrait de Parfum that comes in the dark red bottle. And then I have the scented body oil, which is, of course, a different type of formulation altogether, but it's the same scent. So this is one that, you know, has been described in many different ways by people. Burnt sugar mixed with synthetics, mixed with mint toothpaste, or like the minty taste of floss. And I agree with all of these things, but somehow it just works. Like, it's just so beautifully blended that you get something really unique out of it. A compliment getter for sure. I'm happy to do a solo unique review on Baccarat Rouge if that's something that you'd be interested in. But yeah, I'm not going to say too much more about it. It is definitely one worth checking out, and this is unisex as well. So here are my recommendations from MFK. I hope you enjoyed them. Let me know down below if you have any other favorites from this fragrance house. And also let me know if you'd like me to do an individual review on any of these, or any others from MFK for that matter, or any other fragrance house. I'm happy to try things out for you. And I have so many videos coming your way, so much to share from the niche space, also from the designer space. So please subscribe to this channel for more. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.